The Philippines' securities regulator has ordered the shutdown of online news website Rappler. That's according to Rappler CEO Maria Ressa herself. In a statement, Ressa shared at the East-West Center International Media Conference in Hawaii, Rappler said the Securities and Exchange Commission has affirmed its earlier decision to revoke the certificates of incorporation of Rappler Incorporated and Rappler Holdings Corporation. It was in 2018 when the SEC ruled that Rappler violated the constitutional prohibition on foreign ownership and control of mass media companies when it received an investment from an international firm. Ressa says they will appeal the decision. The SEC, meanwhile, has yet to confirm or comment on the supposed shutdown order. Rappler, which has been critical of Philippine President Rodrigo Duterte's war against illegal drugs, has been facing several cases filed by the government, including cyber libel, and describes the charges and acts against it as an attack on press freedom.
America's second gentleman, Douglas Emhoff, has arrived in Manila. Emhoff, who is the husband of U.S. Vice President Kamala Harris, is leading the American government delegation to the June 30th inauguration of Philippine President-elect Marcos Jr. China's vice president is meanwhile representing Chinese leader Xi Jinping at the event. Joyce Valancio gives us more details on the preparations for tomorrow's ceremony.
President-elect Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr.'s inauguration on June 30 will be simple, solemn, and traditional. France Imperial, one of the heads of the preparation committee, says the program is all set, except for some minor details that are still being finalized. Just like what Marcos said in his vlog, they will stick to tradition during the presidential inauguration. On the morning of June 30, President-elect Marcos will visit the Malacañang Palace to greet outgoing President Rodrigo Duterte, after which Duterte will be given departure honors. Marcos will then proceed to the National Museum for the inaugural ceremony. The program will start with TV host and actress Tony Gonzaga singing the Philippine National Anthem. After this, the ecumenical invocation will follow. A 30-minute military and civic parade will then be held, and the inaugural song, Pilipinas Kumahal, will be performed by artist Chris Villonco and the Young Voices of the Philippines Choir. The Senate President will read the joint resolution by the National Board of Canvassers proclaiming Marcos and Vice President-elect Sara Duterte. At exactly 12 noon, Marcos will take his oath before Supreme Court Chief Justice Alexander Hismundo to be followed by a 21-gun salute. Marcos will then deliver his inaugural speech. His camp has not yet bared the contents of the message. An inaugural reception for other officials and foreign dignitaries will be held after, still at the National Museum. Marcos will then go back to the palace to formally assume office. There, he will administer the oath of his cabinet members and will host an inaugural dinner for the guests. A concert will be held in Mindiola in the evening. According to the Department of Interior and Local Government, around 1,250 guests are expected at the National Museum. Around 18,000 policemen, firemen, soldiers, and emergency services personnel will be deployed in Manila.
Tinitingnan natin, no, pinaluluwag yung lugar para doon sa ibigay ito dito sa mga pupunta rito natin, mga kababayan, supporters ng ating mahal na Pangulo. Tinitingnan natin kaya nagtatanggal na ng iba pang mga chain barrier, tinitingnan din natin yan, at para mapaluwag pa natin yung lugar.
The Interior Department appeals to the local governments to provide venues for public viewing of the inauguration.
Kami po ay we also encourage the different local government units na mag-sponsor ng mga live streaming sa kanikanilang mga lugar para po doon sa mga kababayan natin ay hindi na kailangan pumunta pa at manood per live non or personally.
While rallies will be allowed in Freedom Parks, the Interior Department is encouraging protesters to stage them online instead.
Ang pakiusap lang po namin sa kanila, please keep your protest peaceful. Huwag na po tayong makipaggit-gitan. Huwag na po nating gawa ng eksena pa ito.
The Manila Police District and the Presidential Security Group also held a dry run for security measures.
What I can tell you today is a simulation of what will happen on April, on June 30.
That's all you can share?
Yes.
Meanwhile, among those who are expected as guests is Chinese Vice President Wang Qishan. He will attend on behalf of Chinese President Xi Jinping. Joyce Balancho, ABS-CBN News.